Well, hello, 3C, and welcome to your next lesson on quadratic relations. We're going to pull a few things together. The stuff is not particularly new. I'm just going to take a look at some of the stuff that we've been talking about quadratic relations. So our topic today, the factored form of a quadratic relation, and our goal, I know how to graph quadratic equations from the factored form and how to get information from the quadratic form of an equation. So we're going to look at a few different examples that I might ask you to do with the factored form. So here we go. Example number one, write the following in factored form. What are the x-intercepts? Okay, so we've got two equations here. One of them is given in vertex form, so that's going to be a little bit more work than this one here. This one here, we just have to factor it, so we're going to factor it. We'll put our two brackets down. I know I have x's at the beginning. And this sign here tells me that the two signs in the brackets are going to be different. So I got to put a plus here and a minus here. And this sign in the middle tells me that the bigger number I find has to go with the negative. So now I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to 21. They're going to multiply to 21 and then subtract to 4. So what multiplies to 21? We got 1 and 21, that certainly doesn't subtract to 4. 2 doesn't go into 21, but 3 does. 3 and 7, and I think that subtracts to 4. So we found it. There actually isn't anything more that multiplies to 21. And I have to put the bigger one here, and so there we go. Now it does ask us what the x-intercepts are. So I need the two x-intercepts. Now remember, the x-intercepts come from the brackets, and it's what makes the bracket zero. So what do I have to stick in for x to cancel out this positive 3? Well, the answer for that is negative 3. And what do I have to stick in for this x that cancels out a negative 7? Well, the answer there will be a positive 7. So this is where it crosses the x-axis. I'm just going to do a little rough sketch here. This is going to cross the x-axis at negative 3 and at positive 7. So negative 3 and positive 7. And of course it's right side up because there's no negative in front of the brackets. So it's going to look something like that. Okay. Now, this next one's a little bit tougher because it's in vertex form. And I can't factor straight from vertex form, so I'm going to have to expand it. So it's going to be y equals negative 2, and then I have to write out that bracket twice. X minus 1, and then add 8. So we've already done this. We've already took switching into standard form. That was back a couple videos ago. So we're going to have a look at this again. X times x gives us x squared. Then we're going to have a negative 1 and another negative 1x, negative 1x, negative 1x. And then lastly, negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. And then we have that plus 8 out there. Now I'm going to simplify what's in the brackets before I put that 2 through the bracket. So it's going to give me x squared minus 2x plus 1, and then a plus 8 on the end. And then I'm going to put that negative 2 through the brackets. Negative 2x squared plus 4x minus 2. That plus 8 doesn't get multiplied by 2, it's just plus 8. And now we put negative 2x squared plus 4x plus 6 when I put those two things together. Negative 2 and a positive 8 go together to give me this plus 6. Well, that was a fair bit of work, but we've still got a little bit of work to do here because I have to put it in factored form. So remember, when I see a negative 2 out front, it means I'm going to have to divide it out. I got to divide each of these by that negative 2. This is getting to be a really long question. So I'm going to put that negative 2 out front, and I'm going to divide each of these things by negative 2. That's going to give me x squared. And 4 divided by negative 2 is negative 2 with an x. And then positive 6 divided by negative 2 is going to give me negative 3. And here's our last step to factoring here. I'm going to put down those two sets of brackets. I know there's x's at the front. I know that this tells me the signs are different, so I'm going to put a plus in one and a minus in the other. And I know that this sign tells me that the bigger number has to go with the negative sign. Now, what multiplies to 3? Well, 3 and 1, that's it. Put a 3 here and a 1 there, and that's done. Now, what are our x-intercepts? Well, the x-intercepts are the things that make the bracket zero. So our x-intercepts in this case, what do I have to put with a positive one? What do I have to stick in for x that will cancel out a positive one? A negative one. What do I have to put in for negative 3 that's going to cancel it out? I have to put in a positive 3. So there are my two x-intercepts. Okay, what's the next question? Use the graph of the following parabolas to write each equation in both vertex and factored form. Well, let's look at the red one first. I'm going to call that A. So we'll start by putting y equals. Now let's start with the factored form. Let's look for the x-intercepts because that'll give us the brackets. So the x-intercepts here are 3 and negative 5. So I know that I have to have something in here that cancels out a negative 5, so a positive 5. And I know the next bracket has to have something to cancel out this positive 3, so it has to have a negative 3. Now, the trouble is what goes out here. We got to see if there's a stretch factor on here. When I go over 1, usually I go up 1. So there is definitely a bit of a stretch factor there. So it looks like I've gone up a little less than a half. So it's maybe a third, maybe a quarter. Let's try another one. If I go over, if it's a quarter, if it's a half, I'll go over 2, up 2. If it's a quarter, I'll go over 4, up 4, which looks like what I've done. So this should be a quarter out in front. Now that I know that stretch factor, and look at here, I got a vertex. What's the vertex of that? Negative 1, negative 4. So I can write this as well as a quarter. And now I've got x. This is negative 1, so I have to put plus 1 squared. And then it's a negative 4, so I put the negative 4 in the end. These two things should be exactly the same. Let's look at the green one. Y equals, we're going to go factored form first. Now the green one's upside down, so I know I need a negative out front. And let's look at our x-intercepts. There's one, and there's one. So our x-intercepts are positive 1 and negative 3. So I need two sets of brackets here. The first bracket, I have to put something in it that's going to cancel out a positive 1. Well, negative 1. So we need x minus 1. And the second bracket, I need to cancel out a negative 3. So it's going to have to be a positive 3, so it's going to be x plus 3. Now, what about, do I need some sort of number out in front here? When I go over 1, I go down 1. Over 2, down 4. It doesn't look like it. It's just a 1. It's been neither stretched nor squished. Now let's write that in vertex form. I still need a negative out front. I need a bracket with a squared on it, though. And here's my vertex. My vertex is negative 1 comma positive 4. So I have to put x plus 1. Remember, it's the opposite sign of the vertex. And then plus 4. And these two things should actually be the same thing if we expanded them out. Part C, this blue one. Well, let's start with vertex form. Y equals, it's upside down as well. So I know I need that negative out front. Let's put down my two sets of brackets and let's find the x-intercepts. I'm going to switch colors here so we can see. There's my two x-intercepts. They are at 6. This is a 6 and this is a 2. So I need something that cancels out a 6 and a 2. And they're both positive, so what cancels out positive numbers are negative numbers. So that has to be negative 6 and negative 2. And of course, I need x's in there as well. Now, this thing definitely looks stretched, so we're going to put a number out there. Here's our vertex form, or our vertex. When I go over 1, I go down 2. So that is going to mean I need a 2 there. Let's just double check it. When I go over 2, if this is a 2 out front, I should go down 2 squared, which is 4, and then double that, which is 8. And this is definitely, yep, that's 8 spaces. So negative 2 is good there. Now let's put that in vertex form. I know I still need that negative 2 out front. I need a squared bracket. And my vertex is at 3 and 8. So that's at 3, 8. So I need an x. Remember, opposite sign. It was a positive 3, so I need a minus 3. And then a positive 8, so a plus 8. So there we go. Let's see what the next one says. It says, choose one of the graphs in example 2 and expand both equations in standard form. They should both be the same equation. Well, let's have a look. I'm going to dual page this so that we can get it. What are we going to do? I don't think I'm going to go for that one. I think I'm going to choose B. I'm going to be easy on myself. I'm going to choose the one that doesn't have the number in front of it because I don't want to do all of this stuff. So let's pick B. B has y equals negative x minus 1 times x plus 3. And it also has y equals negative x plus 1 squared plus 4. Okay, single display. Let's go back over here. I'm going to leave the negative there, and I'm going to expand this out. So x times x is x squared. X times 3 is plus 3x. Negative x and negative 1 times 3 is negative 3. That's negative x squared plus 3x minus 1x is 2x minus 3. And of course, this negative out front, to get it all in standard form, is just going to change all those signs. So it's going to be minus x squared minus 2x plus 3. Well, now we got to expand this one out. Going to be the negative out there, and then we have x plus 1 times x plus 1. That's what that squared means, remembered? Plus 4. Going to leave that negative out there. Let's expand this out. X times x is x squared. Then I have x times 1 and x times 1. That means I have two 1x's in there. And then 1 times 1 is plus 1. Got that plus 4 on the end. Now, that negative out front is going to switch all those signs. So we're going to have negative x squared minus x minus x minus 1. And then it doesn't touch the 4, still a plus 4 because the 4 is not in the brackets. And now when I'm putting everything together, I got two negative x's. So that's going to be negative 2x. And a negative 1 and a positive 4 give me a positive 3. Well, look at that. That is, in fact, the same as that one. Okay, last example. Our last example says, find the vertex of the given equation and graph it on the grid provided. Oh, we've done one like this before. This shouldn't be a big deal. The x-intercepts of this, remember, it's what I got to stick in for x. It's going to cancel out what's in the brackets. So it's going to be 3 and 7. Now, how do I find the x-coordinate of the vertex? I take the average of those x's. So it's going to be 3 plus 7 divided by 2. Well, that's 10 over 2, or 5. So the x-coordinate of the vertex is 5. Now the y-coordinate, I have to take the 5 from here and plug it back in up there. Y equals negative 1 half, 5 minus 3, times 5 minus 7. So that's going to be negative 1 half. 5 minus 3 is 2, and 5 minus 7 is negative 2. And so that's going to be negative 4, and we have to take half of negative 4, a negative half of negative 4, it's going to be positive 2. So the y-coordinate, here's the vertex. The vertex is going to be 5, comma 2. So let's go up here. We got 5, comma 2 is going to be right there. And then we've got these two other things. The x-intercepts are at 3 and at 7. 5, 6, 7. There we go. And we know that it's opening down with that half. This is enough to draw it. But I also know that if I go over 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 from the vertex, normally I go down 4 squared, which is 16. Well, I have to do half of that. So I'm going to get one more point here and go down 8. 2, 4, 6, 8. And over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 4, 6, 8. There we are. And over 1 will be down a half, 2. So we've got like that. And the bottom just said, now graph the 3 points you have found. And you can find more by using the A value in the vertex point, which I did. But there's our graph. And that concludes this video. Thank you for watching.